From an early age, we typically interact with our peers in a social group. Imagine what life would be like if you couldn't sense yourself, let alone your environment, the way the rest of us do. What if you couldn't properly feel your own body? How would you control it? How would you connect your intentions to your actions? What if you didn't understand the environment? If you couldn't make sense of your own body and your own world, how could you possibly interact with other people around you? What if nobody else understood? This is autism, a disorder characterized by repetitive behaviors and impaired social interaction. There is, at present, no clear connection between these two behavioral markers, but movement and its sensation is inevitably present in both social interactions and repetitive behaviors.
I think he does that to feel his body. I don't think he can feel his body like we can, and we try to give him ways to get that feedback.
When he was little, he didn't know where his limbs were in relation to his body. He had a really hard time.
She doesn't know where she is in space. I mean, sometimes she'll just like start falling over.
What if biology already found a clever way to provide the proper feedback and bypass corrupted sensory signal that could be too much or too little? Biology does this all the time, as when a blind person echolocates. When you lose one sense, other senses compensate for that loss. This is called sensory substitution. What if the autistic system did the same thing, using movement of the body to self-modulate the sensory input? Perhaps movement can act as a filter to dampen sensory information that is too rich, or to amplify sensory information that is corrupted or insufficient. We reason that we could mimic what biology may have done in autism and augment sensory input by using the real-time movements of the child in closed loop with external media to co-adapt the child and media so as to, without any instruction, have nonverbal children with autism connect with us and let us know what type of sensory media is the most rewarding to them. In this way, we aim at evoking a connection between their actions and their intentions, a connection that was not there before. We created an interface that closes the loop between external media and real-time movement. We created a contingency whereby any time the hand passed through a defined region of interest, the external media was triggered. Of course, the child does not know about this region and is not given any explicit instruction to seek it, and yet comes to discover, using exploratory movements, where this region of interest is, and then deliberately searches for it until he or she finds the posture that continuously plays the media and maximizes reward. The child develops volitional control over actions, a form of control that was not there before, and this is in itself highly rewarding to these children. This girl is very intrigued by seeing herself, to the point that she spontaneously, out loud, asks, "What's happening?"
What's happening?
She spontaneously explores the situation using both facial gestures and hand motions. She sustains interest in exploring this cause and effect phenomena because it is under her control. This girl is nonverbal as well, and usually has trouble initiating and controlling action. She needs some encouragement to initiate exploration on her own, but soon she can detect the external change.
I don't have to be there. You can do it all by yourself. You're too much.
This ability, in and of itself, turns out to be highly rewarding to her. And it leads to a social situation.
I see!
This boy is also nonverbal. He expresses interest in the media once he discovers the cause and effect phenomena that allow him to actively control video playback. You can see that, initially, he is curious, and then he appears to figure things out and deliberately explores to keep watching. Finally, he finds the exact region and holds his hand steady to watch the whole video. And so, with this form of sensory motor substitution, we have connected his intention to his action. Stay tuned, there's more to come.